Do you have wounds that take a very long time to heal? Chronic wounds affect 1 in 100 people over the age of 75. Dr. Ajay Bhatt, he's the medical director of the Wound Healing Center at the Queen's Medical Center, joining us more with this morning's Ask a Specialist with the topic of chronic wounds. Good morning to you, doctor.
Good morning.
Why does that happen? And what happens? What's happening there in our bodies that some people just have chronic wounds?
So a chronic wound is basically a tear in the skin that's been present for approximately 4 weeks or longer. And there's often an underlying cause or an underlying disorder that keeps that wound from healing. So some of the things that can cause a wound from healing are acute infection. Mm-hmm. So treating that infection with antibiotics or getting a swab of that wound is very important. Malnutrition is also another important cause of chronic wounds. So maintaining a good amount of protein in your diet mm-hmm. is very important. Offloading is another. So patients who have limited mobility or cannot turn can often develop these wounds. And then diabetes and peripheral arterial disease kind of go hand in hand. These are wounds that we often see on the lower extremities or the feet.
You mentioned PAD. What is that about? And there's often concern with PAD and chronic wounds.
So PAD is basically a narrowing of some of the arteries that go down to the mm-hmm. foot.
So what are we seeing at home?
So essentially, if you have decreased blood flow from the heart down to the feet, you have just decreased perfusion or decreased oxygen to the area that's affected. So whenever you have decreased oxygen to that tissue, it has a very difficult time to heal. And as a result, you get a chronic wound.
So I can imagine that's very dangerous. And there are some, like you said, narrowing of the arteries. What else can happen with chronic wounds and PAD?
You can get what's called gangrene, which is essentially the wound itself cannot heal, and essentially the surrounding skin around it dies. But there are some things that can be done to try to restore that blood flow or to revascularize that artery.
Please tell us, prevention is possible.
Prevention is extremely important. So I think one of the things that can really help is diet control, mm-hmm. Especially in our diabetic patients. We often check what's called a hemoglobin A1C. And the hemoglobin A1C is basically a 3-month level of a blood glucose. On our diabetic patients, we try to have that blood glucose or A1C level less than 7. If you have a chronic wound and are a diabetic, I think it's a good idea to go and see your primary provider, your physician early.
And like, or a wound care center that's such as that you help and run. And boy, if you have a history of diabetes, it's something that's a red flag for all families. So you want to learn more about wound care, join Dr. Ajay Bhatt and two other specialists for the Queen's Medical Center West Wall Campus. They have a speaking of health lecture free. It's called Wound Care and Saving Your Limbs. That's happening Thursday, July 21st from 6 to 7 over at the West Oahu campus. Again, to register, go to the Queen's referral line at that number 691-7117 or go to our website, kho12.com, to sign up for a link that can happen online. And it's, again, it's about saving your limbs, and there are ways that you can get it done.
Yes.
You don't have to be suffer from chronic wounds.
That's correct.
Doctor, thank you very much. Very interesting topic that I know affects a lot of folks here in Hawaii. Coming up next, volume definitely picking up on our roads. Taizo has that eyes on what's happening on Kalakaua Avenue, how it could affect